Hosea chapter 3. Many of you have been reading, and I've already read the book of Hosea to be prepared for this sermon series, The Power of Love. Chapter 3 is what probably some of you all have been waiting for. Chapter 3 is what many of us know about the book of Hosea. It's not an easy book to read.
Right.
It ought to be a convicting book to read. Whether this is your sin or not, the reality is it speaks to something deeper that people can't see. It speaks about the heart. Hosea chapter 3. It's only 5 verses. Interesting enough, it's a deep book, but only 5 verses. Then the Lord said to me, go again, show love to a woman whom is loved by another man and is an adulteress. Just as the Lord loves the Israelites, though they return to other gods and love Patty LaBelle pies, raisin cakes. They love raisin cakes. So I bought her 15 shekels of silver, 5 bushels of barley. I said to her, you must live with me many days. But while you live with me, don't be promiscuous. Don't belong to any other man. And I will act the same way towards you. Verse 4 and 5 concludes this chapter by saying, for the Israelites also must live days without a king or a prince, without sacrifice, without sacred pillar, without an ephod or household idol. Afterwards, the people of Israel will return and seek the Lord their God and David their king. They will come with awe to the Lord and to his goodness in the last days. I want to preach just briefly this morning with this subject title in mind, if loving you is wrong. If loving you is wrong. Some of y'all have a flashback thinking about Luther anymore. Loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. Loving you is wrong. My brothers and sisters, you either had to be living under a rock these past 3 years, not to realize the new wave of entertainment that has been on our television screens. Either you are living under a rock or you don't have a TV to realize that in the past few years, the world has put shows that have enamored people, in fact, have made Bible classes empty on Wednesday. Because folks don't want to miss their show. In fact, many of us get upset when we find out it's the last episode and we have to wait all the way to another year before the show comes back on. There are so many shows that have enamored us, such as Empire, Power, Scandal. There are shows such as If Loving You Is Wrong, Tyler Perry's edition. All of these shows, or Loving Mary Jane, all of these shows take up our weekly visual broadcast. We literally watch these shows on a weekly. Many of you say, Pastor, I don't watch those shows. But even if you don't watch it, you know something about it. And even in these shows, Jeremy, a lot of these shows push stuff in our face. If you haven't realized it, to get us ready for same-sex marriage, they push same-sex relationships in our face. They've been doing it for years. And to push other stuff in our face and to make us think that this is normal, Sister Austin, they literally put it in our face on a weekly basis to make us feel like this is how life is supposed to be. And one of these shows, If Loving You Is Wrong, is one that I've come to love in a major way. I usually preach and speak against these shows, but for some reason I can't miss if loving you is wrong. But what I don't like about these shows, Sister Collins, is the fact they present to us a bad perception or an incorrect perception of what love is. Most of these shows are about love and power, love and control. It's about companionship. And most of these shows gives us a bad perception or an incorrect perception of what love is. They make us think that love is something you can find every 2 or 3 weeks. Love is something you can find quickly in a restroom, something you can find quickly in an Oval Office, or it's something that you can battle with 2 or 3 more companions. Each of these shows, if you haven't been paying attention, they do not show you the value of commitment, but what they try to show you is that you have to keep your options open. I mean, there are so many shows that you don't even understand who they are in love with today. Today is somebody else, but the next show is somebody else we ain't seen in a couple of seasons, because the reality is they show us that love is something we must test, and love is something we must try out. But can I be honest with y'all real quick this morning, that love does not come in quickies. Love does not come in back and forth relationship. Love does not come in money. Love does not come in position. But love is presented to us in a nice prepackaged, but sometimes ugly way. If you be honest with me, in fact, it was Maya Roberts who said that real love does not look like a flower, but real love looks like a tree. It's the type of love that stands through tests and times, the type of love that goes through storms, and even though storms come and storms go, and even though the tree may not be tended to, that even at the end of the season, that love still stands, because love, people of God, does not make you feel good all the time. Love, people of God, doesn't make you and buy you things all the time, but sometimes love hurts it. Sometimes love bruises you. But when love ought to teach us is, love is steadfast, love is long-suffering, love is patient, love is kind, love never fails. Because that love smells good and looks good. That's what these TV shows teach us, is that men look for love in different ways and women look for love in different ways. And because women can't find a man that's faithful to them, that's going to be committed to them, they'll take an ugly man as long as he smells good and dressed right. Y'all ain't going to help me here. They'll take an ugly man, whether he got money, he can give them a car, because women have been taught that love is secure when they got a nice car to drive, when they got a nice house, when they got position. But I'm looking for telling y'all that, you know what? That ain't what love looks like. Because sometimes love will have you in a house with the lights out. Y'all ain't preaching with me. Sometimes love will make you go to the store with $2 in your pocket. When your love says, baby, you ain't got it, I ain't got it, and we gon' suffer together. To understand this idea of love, to understand what love really looks like, you don't have to look on TV. You don't have to look at other couples. You don't have to look what their profile picture says on Facebook. If you want to understand love, all you got to do is pick up a Bible. Y'all may help me preach. And the best example of love is not what you see on screen, but it's what you see on the pages of your Bible. And that's the love that Jesus gave. Jesus paid it all hard to him. I owe him. That's not the crimson stain, but Jesus washed me white as snow. That's what love does. Look at our text here. Hosea opens up in a strange way. Last time I talked to you about Hosea, you remember God told him to marry a woman. This woman who
became promiscuous. Y'all remember that?
Yeah.
Had three children. One child he knew was healed. Second child he kind of figured was healed. But the third child he knew was not healed at all.
Right.
And God used that prophet to show to Israel that that's how God's relationship to Israel is that God, that Israel is like that bride who leaves her husband to be promiscuous. And even though that in the beginning they're God's children, in the middle they stop looking like somebody else's child, but in the third child, because you don't look like me, you don't act like me, and you don't even have the same blood as me, but then it shows you in chapter 1 that even though God gives you all of this, that by the end of chapter 1, God says, but this is what I'll do for you. But watch how verse 1 opens. The woman has left Hosea. The woman has literally, the woman in chapter 1 is no longer promiscuous while she's married. She's not even with her man no more.
All right now.
Verse 1 open says, then the Lord says to me, go again, show love to a woman who is loved by another man. I want you to catch this. Notice he doesn't say, go again and tell the woman you love, who's with somebody else, but he says, go and show.
Yeah.
It's so easy, church,
yeah,
to tell folk you love them.
Right.
It's so easy to tell folk what you'll do for them.
Yeah.
It's so easy to tell people how good they're looking. It's so easy to tell your spouse how much they mean to you. But what God is showing us in this book, that love is not about telling, but God wants us to know that love is about showing. It's about showcasing what someone means to you. No matter how they look, no matter how they act, no matter what they do, that when real love is present, it's about showing. And it does not show up on February 14th. It don't just show up on your birthday. It